Good morning, students. I hope you all are well. So, as we are doing our chapter number 15, natural calamities, and in this we have discussed that the natural calamities or the natural disaster, they are caused by the force of nature. And we have already discussed there are different types of natural calamities like earthquake, cyclone, volcano, and flood. Drought is also there and famine is also there. So they are the different types of natural calamities. And we have already discussed about the earthquake. And we have discussed that earthquake is caused due to movement of the earth crust, and that will lead to destruction of human life and property. And the region where the earthquake start under the earth crust is known as focus, and the region just above the focus on the earth crust is known as epicenter. Whereas epicenter is a region where the largest destruction of human life and property takes place as a result of अर्थक्वेक. सबसे ज्यादा जो डिस्ट्रक्शन होता है अर्थक्वेक की वजह से वो एपिसेंटर वाले रीजन पे होता है. एंड देन देयर इज अ ट्रीमर्स और द माइल्डर ट्रीमर्स आर फॉलोड आफ्टर द अर्थक्वेक आफ्टर अ वेरी फास्ट अर्थक्वेक बिकॉज द क्रस्ट आर अलाइंड देमसेल्फ टू देयर पोजिशन बैक. And after this, we have also discussed that there is an instrument which is developed by the scientist philosopher that is known as the seismograph, which is used to measure the direction, measure the intensity of the earthquake. Then after that, there is a scale is also there that is known as Richter scale that is used to measure the magnitude of the earthquake. And the earthquake, if it is magnitude in more than 6, that will lead to large destruction of human life and property. And after this, we have discussed about the what are the safety measures that we have to follow. So we do not have to become panic at that time when there is an earthquake, and we should keep ourselves away from the tall buildings and from the electric wires. And if we have to go to different places, then we should use the staircase in spite of using the lifts and the elevators. And if we are at home inside the room, then we have to hide ourselves under the table or under the bed. So this is about the earthquake, and today we will discuss about the other natural calamity which are known as cyclones and flood. And student, if we talk about these cyclones and the flood, the cyclones can be seen in the coastal areas, and they are result due to rising in the sea water level and leads to submerging of the coastal areas. And there will also result in the heavy rainfall and storm in the coastal areas. And the flood are caused when there is a accumulation of the rainwater over the land, and that is known as flood, and it leads to lots of destruction of the human life and property. So cyclones, they occur in the coastal areas. Along with it, storm and heavy rainfall occur. So they occur in the coastal areas. The main thing is that, and along with it, storms are there and the rainfall also occur. But what is flood? When the rainwater accumulate on the earth surface, then there is a flood. When rainwater accumulate on the earth surface, and property. And along with it, it also leads to submerging of coastal areas in water. As a result of this flood, the sea level, the water in the sea level rises up and causes submerging of the coastal areas. And after this, what are the effects of cyclones and flood? So, what are the effects of floods? What will be the effect? First, it causes destruction of human life and property. Causes damage to crops and loss to farms. As the water accumulates over the earth's surface, that will also leads to lots of waterborne diseases. Result in a number of waterborne diseases like typhoid, dysentery, third, destruction of human life and property. Next is, as a result of this flood, the topsoil get eroded and the soil become infertile. Topsoil eroded and the soil become infertile. And as a result of this flood also, the animals living in the soil, such as the snakes, ants, they also die. That will lead to death of many animals like snake, ants and rats. Many animals like snake and etc. die, or death of the animals, many animals occur as a result of this flood. So the next natural calamity is drought, and it is just the opposite of flood and the volcanoes. It is just the opposite of flood and the volcano. As in flood and volcano, there is a lots of rainfall. There is a heavy rainfall, and in this region, when there is a in a particular region, there is a very little rainfall or no rainfall for a particular period of time, that is known as drought. So it occurs in the areas when there is very little or no rainfall for a long period of time. Then the condition is known as drought. आप हिंदी में बोलते हैं सूखा, जब किसी भी जगह पे. एंड when there is a particular region gets a very little or a no rainfall for a period of time, then it is known as drought. And student, what happened? This will leads to very less surface and the ground water. As a result of this, there will be shortage of surface and the ground water. There will be shortage of surface and ground wood. This is the next condition. When there will be a drought, there will be shortage of the surface and the ground water. The surface water that is present in the water bodies like rivers, ponds, lakes, and ground water, underground water that is present under the surface of earth. So as a result of this, the ponds, the lakes, they dry up. As a result of this, what happened? The water bodies like ponds, lakes, rivers, etc. dry up. They dry up, and as a result of this, the water bodies getting dry up, the wind will be hot and dry. According to this, as a result of this, the wind also become dry and hot. The wind become dry and hot. And the regions where the drought generally takes place are the Rajasthan is there, Maharashtra is there. States in India where the drought takes place mostly, or this drought occur, are Rajasthan, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Karnataka. And after this, student, what are the effects of this drought? इससे क्या effect पड़ता है human life पे और property पे? So effects of drought. So student, generally as we all know that we depend on the rain to irrigation. For the irrigation of the crop. In India, we mostly depend on the rain for the irrigation of the crop. And if there is no rainfall, it means the crop production will reduce or decrease. So, there will be no crop production. There will be less production of the crop. So, crops get destroyed. Crops get destroyed. There will be shortage of water. There will be severe shortage of water. And as a result of this, if there is a shortage of water in a particular region, the people migrate from that particular region to the other places. Then mass movement of people from one place to another. Movement of people from one place to another, and there will be shortage of food and water also, because there is no water and we need water for growing of crops, so food will be not there, so there will be shortage of food and water. And student, if this drought condition will remain for a long period of time, that is known as famine. And famine means akal. Drought means sukha, and famine means akal. If the condition will remain for a long period of time, the drought condition, then there will be a famine, and that will develop into a epidemic, which may lead to a epidemic condition. So, drought result in famine and leads to epidemic. So, student, this is about the drought. When there is no rainfall or a little rainfall, it will lead to drought. And if the condition will remain for a long period of time, as a result of this, there will be shortage of surface water, underground water will also become less. And as a result of this, the water bodies, like ponds, lakes, they dry up, and the wind become dry and hot in that particular region. And after this, what are the effects of drought? Crops get destroyed. Because if you do not get the proper water for the irrigation, there will be the crops get destroyed. There will be severe shortage of water. And movement of people from one place to another. If the people do not get a sufficient amount of water, so they will move from one place to another places. And after this, if the crop is also destroyed, so the people will not get the food. So there will be shortage of food and water. And lastly, if the condition of the drought will remain for a long period of time, it will known as famine, and this will lead to epidemic. So student, next we will discuss about the other natural calamity, that is volcanoes. So student, next natural calamity is the volcano. And student, as when we have discussed about the earth layers, there we have discussed that the earth is divided layer in earth crust is divided into three main layers: crust, uppermost layer, mantle, and the core. And inside the core, it is molten rocks are present, that is known as magma, and that magma is moving continuously. And on the earth crust, there is a vent or opening is present through which this molten rocks, the magma, comes on the surface of earth, that is known as lava. And this lava cools down and result in the formation of igneous rocks. So this volcano can also occur inside the sea water. And next is, and what are the volcanoes? They are the cracks in the earth crust through which the molten rocks come on the surface of earth. So what are volcanoes? They are, volcano means opening in the earth crust through which magma comes out along with gases and ash. The student, these are the openings or the cracks. Volcanoes, they are the openings of the cracks. They are present in the earth crust will present over there, through which the magma, that is the molten rocks, come on the surface of earth. Along with it, the gases and ashes also come. So student, on the basis of this intensity . So student, this volcano can be classified into three types on the basis of their frequency of eruption. When they have erupted, on the basis of that, they have classified into three types. The first one is the active volcano. Second is the dormant volcano. And the third is the extinct volcano. So this first one is the active, or the first is the active volcano. So these are the volcanoes that have erupted in recent years, and there are the chances of eruption again. They have erupted in recent years, and there is a chance of eruption of these volcano again. And erupted in recent years and can erupt again are known as active volcano. So student, these are the most dangerous type of volcano, and they are mostly generally occur around the Pacific ocean. So the Pacific Ocean is also known as, and there are about to 500 active volcano around the world. 500 active volcano around the world, and from this the mostly are present around the Pacific Ocean. So the Pacific Ocean is also known as, they occur mostly around the or near the Pacific Ocean. That's why the Pacific Ocean is known as Pacific Ring of Fire. And student, if we talk about the most active, a few active volcanoes, the Mount Etna, is the active volcano. So if we talk, so student, if we talk about the active examples of active volcano, the Mount Etna, Mount Fuji, etc. are the examples of active volcano. And if we talk about the active volcano in India, it is the, if we talk about the active volcano present in India, that is the Barren Island, Barren Island in Andaman, Nicobar. Barren Island is in Andaman Nicobar is the active volcano in India, and it has been erupted in the 1787. It lastly erupted in the 1787. So next is the dormant volcano. The second type of the volcano is the dormant. So dormant volcano are the volcano that have not erupted in recent years, but they can erupt in coming years. So student, if we talk about the dormant volcano are the volcano that have not erupted in recent years, but can erupt in coming future. And if we talk about the example, Mount Kilimanjaro in India and the Jija, Mount at Jija in Kerala, Mount Adjija in Canada is an example of dormant volcano. Along with it, Adjija is an example of dormant volcano. Next, if we talk about the third type of volcano, are the extinct volcano. And extinct volcano are the volcano that have not erupted in recent years, and there is a no chance, or there is a less chance of eruption of these volcanoes in coming future. So these are not very dangerous. These are the third type of volcano that have not erupted in the recent years, and there is a no chance of eruption in the future also. So these are not very dangerous. The extinct type of volcano are not very dangerous. So if we talk about the example of extinct volcano, the Mount Ashitaka in Japan is an example of extinct volcano. So students, next we will discuss about the types. What are types? Student, the last natural calamity is the tidal waves. So as we have already studied in our previous chapter, that the cyclic rise and fall in the sea water due to the gravitational pull of the moon and the sun is known as tidal waves. So the cyclic rise in the sea water due to gravitational pull of the moon and the sun is called tidal waves. And the student, generally what happened, due to the gravitational pull of the sun and the moon, the water in the seas and the oceans dries up. And the part of the, when the earth rotates, the part of the earth or the sea towards the earth, moon, the level of that water will rises up and the other region there will be a low tide will be created. And this causes destruction in the coastal areas. And the maximum height of the rise, water rise will occur when the sun, moon and the earth come in a straight line and at the time of lunar eclipse. This occurs at the time of lunar eclipse when there will be a maximum rise in the height of the sea water. The student, generally what happened, these all are the natural calamities that occurs naturally. So there will be the maximum. The student, the tides reaches the maximum height when the sun, moon and the earth come in straight line. So when the sun, moon and the earth, when the sun, moon and the earth come in a straight line, then there will be a maximum height of the tide. And this occurs when there will be a lunar eclipse. This they come in straight line when there will be a lunar eclipse. So student, as these natural calamities can occur in any country at any time, and this affects the progress of that particular country in which this type of natural calamities are occurring. So at that time what happened, it's our duty, it's the duty of all people of the world that we have to stand to help the people who are in need. And we can contribute or we can help them by contributing food to them, by giving medicines to them and by giving cash to the agencies which are working the people, which are helping this type of people who are in need. So, and student, we can give cash to the agencies. We can help these people who are in need by contributing food, by contributing medicines and by contributing cash to the agencies who are involved in the relief work. And there are some agencies like UNICEF is there, WHO is there and Red Cross Society, etc. So these are the some agencies that are involved in the relief work and all over the world, and they help the people who are in need. So student, this is the last topic of this chapter. In this chapter we have learned about the different types of natural calamities, like about the earthquake and what are the safety measures that we have to follow at the time of earthquake. We have already learned about it, how we can measure the intensity of the earthquake and how the instrument like the Richter scale is there, which is used to measure the magnitude of the earthquake. And after that we have discussed about the cyclone and the flood. And cyclone and flood occur in the sea coast areas. And the cyclone occur when there will be heavy rainfall and along with it storm are there. And flood occur when there is the rainfall water. The water of the rain accumulate on the earth surface, and that will lead to destruction of human life and property. The people migrate from one places to another, and there are large number of waterborne diseases also appear at that time. And then we have discussed about the volcanoes, and they are the three types: extinct volcano, active volcano, and the dormant volcano. And in this, the active volcano is the dangerous and one. And lastly, we have discussed about the tidal waves. And tidal waves means the rise and fall in the sea water, and that is due to the gravitational pull of the sun and the moon. And for this last, we have discussed that these calamities can occur in any country, and for this there are some agencies are there who involved in the relief work all over the world, like UNICEF, WHO is there. So we can also help them, we can also help these people by contributing food, by contributing medicines, and by giving cash to these agencies. So student, this is all about your chapter. That's all for today. Thank you and have a nice day.